Donc BBE Développement est une société française, c'est un organisme de formation où nous dispensons des formations sur la conduite de véhicules en intervention. Ils sont très friands de nos méthodes françaises ou européennes, de manière à faire monter en compétences leurs différentes forces armées. Et du coup, aujourd'hui, on leur propose en fait notre expertise française et de la mettre au service de leurs forces locales, soit en leur apportant directement nos formations, soit en faisant du transfert de compétences auprès de formateurs locaux pour que derrière, ils puissent être autonomes dans le déploiement de nos formations. Et bien déjà, c'est de pouvoir éventuellement rencontrer tous les acteurs de la sécurité et de la défense du continent africain, qui est pour nous un marché à fort potentiel et qui est aujourd'hui très intéressé par justement, on va dire, calquer leur méthode d'approche sur ce qui est fait en France notamment et sur d'autres pays d'Europe. Et donc forcément, on s'est dit que notre expertise pouvait les intéresser et renforcer les compétences de leurs forces armées ou forces de sécurité.
So my name is Guillaume Giscard d'Estaing. I'm the chairman and CEO to Sofema. Sofema is a company which is dedicated to offering to those countries that cannot buy state-of-the-art latest technology equipment. For those customers, we offer a product which they can afford, which they can buy with a very short notice, and which is coming from surplus equipment which Sofema acquires, refurbishes, modernizes, upgrades and sells to the customer with a package of support and training. This is a very generic description, of course. The principle of the business generated by Sofema is that we do not start from our products. We always start with our customers' requirements. This type of weapon, first, is a weapon which has been developed by Sofema. Originally, this is a double-gun anti-air weapon. We have realized that there were very little chances to sell this weapon as is, and we have decided to build a completely new solution, which has been designed as a low-tech, low-cost option. To be proposed to customers desiring to have a caliber which is roughly of greater importance in comparison with what you can find on the marketplace. So it has been designed by Sofema with the help of a design office, and we are now starting our production. Sofema offer, as I told you previously, is an offer which is cheaper than brand new latest generation technologies. So this is something to be considered in terms of price. Beyond prices, there is a second matter which is of great importance. Most of these equipment already exist. They are on stock within Sofema's stocks. That is to say, should one of those customers wishing to acquire one of our equipment, the lead time is very short. And it's not only a matter of price again, it's a matter of having the equipment available at short notice and at low price. And the combination of the two, I think, is a discriminator when it comes to commercial matters.
GK Pro a été fondée par Monsieur Georges Cumuchian. Elle a maintenant une existence de 35 ans. Nous sommes concepteurs, fabricants et développeurs. On travaille énormément sur la France et on se développe aussi énormément sur l'Afrique, donc ce qui nous permet de pouvoir prendre divers contacts avec différents pays. Nous avons un bureau d'études sur la France. Et nous travaillons sur les cahiers des charges que les pays nous fournissent. Nous sommes aussi fournisseurs exclusifs sur le territoire français, sur tout ce qui est balistique, et maintien de l'ordre. Nous développons donc tout ce qui est étuis pour les ministères. Donc ce sont des étuis avec un système de rétention, donc sécurisé. Ensuite, nous avons aussi tout ce qui est tenu par coup, donc tout ce qui est pour maintien de l'ordre, avec des protections qui peuvent se terminer avec des avant-bras, avec des jambières. Et vous avez aussi la possibilité de pouvoir y intégrer tout ce qui est pack balistique. Nous avons tout ce qui est aussi tenue de cérémonie. Donc en l'occurrence, là, nous avons une tenue qui a été faite pour la GP du Cameroun. On travaille pas mal sur l'Afrique de l'Ouest, subsaharienne et Centrafrique, et aussi sur tout ce qui est pays du Moyen-Orient et Asie.
We at Arcus are very much focused on Africa. We have a lot of activities in the region, of course not only in Ivory Coast, but in the whole African continent. We are proud to offer a very competitive and very good range of products which is fitted for African conditions. And we have customers in the whole regions providing some light and medium heavy tactical and armored vehicle. We have, I think, a good pedigree in Africa with the Akmat and Power and Renault brands, which are, as you know, the components of Arcus. Then we have a long experience, and I think we have products which are very well fitted to the specific conditions in climate, in road conditions of the African continent. We have also a good track record and good service backup for all the vehicles which are being used both by the African Armed Forces but also by the French Armed Forces which are operating throughout Africa. We have battle-proven equipment and of course now which are becoming somehow, especially this Bastion vehicle you see behind me, becoming a little bit like bestsellers, I would say, and used by a lot of African forces involved in the ongoing peacekeeping operations in the Sahel in particular. Well, first of all, to continue being aware that they need to invest in security and defense, which is definitely the base for stability and economic development. Second, that they need also to take care about the kind of long-term vision on how to build capabilities in defense, including, of course, you know, programming and planning for the equipment itself, but also for the maintenance part of the fleet, which is so important, of course, to keep a good operational availability of the equipment. So that would be my main messages.
I am Thierry Duquesne. I am the director of the light range, which means all the vehicles that between 3.5 ton GVW and 20 ton. So effectively, we are introduced, if you remember, in 2011, the first vehicle, which was the LTV1, with a base on the commercial large range of commercial vehicle. So now we decide in 2017 to pass on the new one. We decide to invest and to change the running base of this vehicle. The concept is the same. We have capitalized on the assets and the strength of the first vehicle. So that means a deep militarization of the base, which means modification of the front suspension, rear suspension. You will see the tactical tray on the rear of the vehicle. So all these assets has been kept for this concept. And we have profit of the experience of the former vehicle by changing the rolling base. Now we are on the Ranger chassis, and this Ranger chassis has a big reliability. We think it's the best vehicle in the world today, and that's why we decide to go on this vehicle. We take a large commercial range vehicle, but we deeply militarize it. That means that we have a large long range of the autonomous. We have more than 800 kilometers. We upgrade the payload and we have the largest surface and volume for the rear tray. We have a like we call the tactical tray, which means that it's a kind of polyvalent. You can have weapon system, you can have transport with a standard pallet, ISO pallet, or you can take 8 people in this rear tray with a large comfort. That's a real vehicle for Africa because of the reliability, and due to the first vehicle, now we have still less electronic device inside. That means that if you can see inside the power pack compartment, you will find quite no wires. All the thing has been made in order to meet to be compliant with the reliability expectation.
Thank you.